What's up, guys? Welcome back to Avion Awesome, another riveting episode here on the channel. So I just released a video today, but I also just watched Nomadic Fanatic's 1000 Trails video. And while he did hit on several of the points that I think were pretty relevant, I wanted to actually give you all a little bit of extra information on 1000 Trails, how it worked when I first started, and how I find that it's working now. So, just like he did, I'm going to start off by assuming that you know absolutely nothing about 1000 Trails. What 1000 Trails essentially is it is a membership. It is a camping membership, okay? As a membership, you pay your fees and your dues all up front. So, if you are like a Costco member or a Sam's Club member, you pay your dues for the year up front, and then you get access to the club, to the membership, that entire year. Well, essentially the exact same thing applies here. What they have is called a camping pass. The camping pass by itself retails for $575 per year. What you get with the camping pass is they have roughly 61 different types of campgrounds littered throughout the United States. It's pretty good. You know, it's average, pretty good average of different types of campgrounds in different places. As he also pointed out, there is not much out in the Midwest. If you live in the Ozarks, you know, Minnesota, Idaho, those places, there's just not much up there in that area. Most of the 1000 Trails campgrounds are all along the coastline. There's a few scattered a little bit further inland. There's one in Kentucky where I'm from. It is a little bit further south overall. There's a couple, maybe two or three that are in Tennessee. And, you know, like I said, you can look at the map and you can find out if this is even going to be worth it to you. If you live up in the Ozarks, if you live in the Midwest, if you live anywhere in that area and you don't do much traveling to the coast, it's probably not going to be a good deal for you. Now, let's assume that you do like to spend a lot of time on the outer edges of the country. So Florida is an excellent place. There are a ton of campgrounds here in Florida. Officially, there's only 3,000 Trails campgrounds here in Florida, but there are probably 40 different Encore resorts in Florida. That was one of the main reasons why I decided to spend my winter here in Florida, was because not only would it give me a perfect opportunity to make sure that, you know, I tested out all of my systems, tested out the rig, see how well it did, how well it performed, but it also allowed me to avoid the cold winter where I'm from. You know, I'm originally from Kentucky. We usually get a pretty decent winter. Being able to stay down here in Florida allowed me to test all the systems out and also really give a good evaluation of the 1000 Trails camping pass. That is what I bought. That's pretty much the only thing that I'm going to focus on here today, is the camping pass, the thing that costs $575. After I evaluated the camping pass, option, I also wanted to include the 1000 Trails collection, because like I said, if you get just the camping pass, you only get access to the little green tree campsites or campgrounds littered throughout the United States. If you add the Trails collection, you get access to the brown pine trees camping locations that are on the map, but you also get access to the blue palm tree locations that are located on the map, which vastly expands the amount of camping that you are going to be able to do. Now, the Trails collection for 1000 Trails is an extra $199, so realistically $200. So if you're paying full retail, which I did not, for the camping pass and the 1000 Trails collection, you're paying roughly $775. In most places, that's 1 month's worth of rent. That's 1 month's worth of mortgage. And that gives you a full year of camping, 365 days per year. Now, I know that a lot of people want to talk about all the different upgrade options and stuff that you can do, because it is a bit like a timeshare. You can upgrade, honestly, if you want to. I find that it's not necessary, and here's why. So when you call into 1000 Trails and you say, hey, I want to sign up, I want to grab one of your camping passes, and yes, I would also like to add the Trails collection. The 1000 Trails camping pass is a complete contract all on its own. And you can read through it, and you can try and understand all the legalese, techno mumbo jumbo, but really you don't have to. I'm going to go ahead and just tell you how it works. Then you also add the Trails collection for the extra $200, and that is a completely separate contract. It is governed by a completely different contract. But if you read the contracts individually, it says something to the effect of, you can stay in the Thousand Trails camping system for up to 14 days, but you have to stay out of our system for 7. Now, when you start talking about how many days in, how many days out, it starts to sound really complicated. Like, most people just go, that just sounds absolutely horrendous. I can't understand what's going on. I don't really get it. 4 days and I can go from park to park and I can stay up to 2 weeks, but then I got to stay out for 7. It really does. It confused me quite a bit when I first signed up for it as well. And when you read the contract, it says if you spend any amount of days, whether it be 1 or 14 in the Encore system, then you have to stay out of our system for 7 days. It just gets really, really confusing. So here is the best way that I can describe it. Right here, right now, at the end of 2018 and into the foreseeable future. If anything ends up changing with the Thousand Trails contracts or systems, I talk to a lot of people that have these, and if they give me any updated information or they allow me to read their contracts, I'll totally update my videos as I learn that new information. Okay, so the biggest, easiest breakdown I can give you is that when I first started, I thought I had to move every 4 days in order to stay in the system. Because according to the contracts, it said, if you stay 4 days or longer, you have to stay out of all of the preserves, they call them preserves, for 7 days. So I was just like, okay, well, I'll just move every 4 days. That way I can stay in the system the entire year. Well, even that is pretty good. You know, if you are young and vital and you don't mind moving around and you maybe have some boondocking experience or some camping or hiking experience, 4 days is nothing. You set up. You spend 4 days, lay back, enjoy your free electric and your water and your sewer, and then you move on to the next place. But you don't have to move every 4 days. You can stay up to 14 days at both places, both Thousand Trails and Encore. I was unaware of this. I was unaware that the Thousand Trails camping pass and the Trails collection are actually governed by two different sets of contracts. So you have one for the one, the other for the other. So if you have to stay out of the Thousand Trails system for 7 days, that does not mean you can't immediately go to an Encore park and then stay for 14 days. So I just figured that out probably like a month ago. So as soon as I figured it out, by reading the contracts really close and then doing some testing on their website, you can officially go to, say, let's just say you started off, you decided to come down to Florida, and you stopped at the Orlando Thousand Trails. It's right there in Claremont, Florida. You can book up to 14 days and stay in that park for a full 14 days. According to that contract, you then have to stay out of the Thousand Trails system for 7 days. Well, the Encore parks are not a part of the Thousand Trails system. So you can immediately go from the Orlando Thousand Trails and then go to any of the blue dots on the map, whether that be Terracea, whether that be the Crystal River, the Barrington, the Space Coast, all those different little blue dots all over the map. You can immediately drive over to one of them. Lake Magic is just down the road. It's about 3 miles away. You can go to the Sherwood Forest, like Nomadic Fanatic. That's about 10 miles down the road from the Orlando Thousand Trails. And you can immediately go to those parks and stay for 14 days, or 7 if you wanted to get right back into the Thousand Trails system. So effectively, cutting through all the mumbo jumbo, the how many numbers you've got, 4 days in, 7 days out, 14 up to, blah, blah, blah. The fact of the matter is that you can stay in any of those parks, Thousand Trails, for 14 days, and you can immediately go to one of the Encore parks and stay for 14 days. I mean, that makes it completely worth it. Out of all of the different systems that I've looked at, Passport America, what, you get 50% off? Well, you're still going to end up spending probably $20 to $40 per night, depending on the resort, depending on the campground, how much demand there is in the system. You're still going to spend some money. But with the Thousand Trails system, you pay that fee up front one time, $700, roughly, $775. I got a 20% discount, and you can stay in Thousand Trails for 2 weeks, and then go to essentially, if you don't want to move. If you don't want to move around a whole lot and you really kind of want to explore your local area once you get to a place, go to Thousand Trails Park and then check out that area for 2 weeks, immediately jump over to an Encore park, stay there for 2 weeks, because technically you're 14 days out of the Thousand Trails system when you're at an Encore, and you're technically 14 days out of the Encore system when you stay at a Thousand Trails. I know it sounds complicated and it's crazy, because once you get it though, once you just grasp it, just know this. If you stay in Thousand Trails for 14 days, you manage to get a 14-day reservation, go to any of those other parks, stay for 14 days, and then just bounce back and forth. That's exactly what I've been doing since I've been here. I'll stay in a Thousand Trails, go grab me a resort somewhere on the coast, check out the beaches, check out the scenery, check out the local area, and then immediately hop back over. So, like, I've almost spent a full 2 weeks here where I'm at in Teresia, just south of St. Petersburg. After I'm done here for 2 weeks, I'm heading over to Peace River, which is in Zolfo Springs, for 2 weeks. And then after I get done in that Thousand Trails, I'm heading back to another Encore park, and I'm going to be there for 2 weeks. So, really, the system is set up so that it does sound a little bit confusing, so that you don't take full advantage of what you've signed up for. But now you know. Some people would be like, why are you telling everybody? Honestly, I want as many people in the system as possible, mainly because I think that if they get more money, they'll have more money to upgrade these parks, they'll have more money to reinvest in these parks, and maybe they'll also have enough money to buy new ones, so that finally, at some point, we might actually see some parks crop up in Colorado, Idaho, and those types of places. So anyway, there are a couple of caveats to the setup. You're not always guaranteed a spot. You're not always guaranteed to get in. With the camping pass, you're only allowed 2 months to reserve your campsites in advance. So during these extremely high peak seasons, especially in Florida, Arizona, Southern California, places like that, of course, they're going to be full all winter long. So if you don't get your reservations in, you might end up having a boondock. So if you don't have yourself set up for either solar or for long extended stays off grid, you're probably not going to want to try to do it full time and depend solely on Thousand Trails. That's the reason you might want to hook up with like Harvest Host, Boondockers Welcome, Passport America, Good Sam's, just whatever it's going to take to maybe get you through a couple of days of not being reserved in a park in the Thousand Trails system. You have to keep those tools in your back pocket in order to make the most of being a full timer. But thus far, I've had zero problems getting into a park. It may not necessarily be the ideal place, like where I really wanted to be at that particular time, but it's not like I haven't been able to get in anywhere. I can always, you know, park my rig in a unideal location and then just drive to wherever I want to spend a few days. But if that kind of seems like it might be a problem for you, or that's just not your idea, you know, you just want to park your rig in the exact city, the exact town, the exact county that you were hoping you would explore for those couple of weeks or whatever, however long you want to stay, you know, you're going to have to be flexible. The number one rule of being a full-time RVer is you're going to have to be flexible. So sometimes you're not always going to get exactly where you want. So really, after I spend my time in Peace River, honestly, the next Encore resort that I'm going to after that, it's not exactly where I wanted to be. I wanted to kind of get a little bit further south and explore the, sort of the Everglades area. But all the parks are full. They're absolutely full. Now, granted, people cancel all the time. You could spend some time on the reservation system and just keep refreshing and hoping that maybe over, you know, because if you're out two months in advance anyway, you can, you know, play around. You've got 2 months to try and get into those other places that you want to be, and hopefully someone will cancel and you can get in just at the right time. But honestly, in my opinion, it's a very, very small price to pay for the vast amount of not only basically free camping, but free electric, free, you know, sewer, free water for an entire year, all for the price of 1 month of rent at a condo or rent at your apartment or for 1 month's mortgage. All right, guys. So I hope that kind of cleared everything up. If you have any extra questions, drop those down in the comment section below. I will do my very best to answer them based on the knowledge that I have right here, right now at this moment. Also, just be aware that Thousand Trails changes stuff all the time. They've had different perks, different packages, different naming conventions for their packages for many, many years. So I have found secondary stuff on the on their upgrade packages. They've used a lot of different names. And if they keep a level of confusion in the equation, people aren't necessarily going to know what they're getting. And I understand that. They don't want necessarily people like us taking full advantage of what we paid for based on our contracts that we signed. So I'm taking full advantage of the contract that I signed, and I'm going to use it to the best of my ability. I highly encourage everyone else to do the same. You should get exactly what you pay for. Maybe they'll close these quote-unquote loopholes or whatever, but I genuinely hope that this just encourages more people to get into the system, helps them make them more money, and maybe expand this system out altogether. At any rate, I hope you guys enjoyed yet another riveting episode here on the Avion Awesome Channel. I'm your host, Mark Puckett. I'm going to see you guys again on the next one. Peace.